How did it begin? How did I get the idea for this? I began thinking one day about this observation that it sometimes seems that religious families have more children than non-religious families. And I mulled this over a little bit, and I didn't want to sort of make this something I was going to think about and write an essay about or an article about or argue with people about so much. But I did start to think, well, what kind of person would be obsessed with this idea? And I imagined a scientist, a passionate atheist, who was concerned that if society continued in this way, then everyone in the world would be religious, and the atheists, the liberals, the social progressives would die out. And I thought, well, what if this scientist wanted to have his own child, to bring a child up in the atheist way? What if this scientist, for medical reasons, could not have children? How would he deal with this? How would his partner, the mother of his child, deal with this if he so desperately wanted children but couldn't have one? And then I thought, well, what kind of a woman would this be? Where would she have got the ideas that gave her the basis to decide how to act, to make this moral choice? I thought perhaps she would have had a father who did make what appeared to be a very clear moral choice and an act of sacrifice, and how would this influence her? And then I thought, well, perhaps to give her some contrast, she would have a brother who had taken a completely different and much darker interpretation of their father's action. And so with this unfolding of characters, the book began to take shape.